it was for Scientology, and it was going to be like quite a bit of money to do a series of audio books. And they were thrilled that I was Jen, and I actually flew out to Los Angeles and met a bunch of these girls in uniforms at the studio that were huge Jen fans, and they were the sweetest people. But it was hardcore Scientology, and I read the material, and I didn't like it. I didn't like it, and it was very homophobic, and that upset me because I'm not, and I know that I have so many gay fans. The show has so many, such a huge gay following, and as kind as they were, I was like, you know.
Yeah, but it takes guts to turn down something and stand up for what you believe in.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
Yeah,
that is awesome.
Thanks. Yeah, it just is the right thing to do. So that was a strange thing, but you just show up and see what it's about, and then you make your decisions based on that.
I'll follow you.
That was the first gem doll I bought, was the glitter and gold one. And in fact, I think I'll bring it tomorrow.
Wow!
You hear him salivating.
I won't even be here. Can you tell the story about how when you went to the store, because I know it's on the DVD, about how your mom was like, this is Jen.
Oh, yeah, they took me, my parents, well, I went with my mom actually to Toys R Us, and she's like, you should put you a Jen doll, and my dad's like, you should, because it'll be worth something one day, and I was like, okay. And then we got a Jen doll, and there was a little girl, and she was trying to pick out a Jen doll, and my mom was with her, and my mom's like, that's Jen. And the little girl's looking at my mom like, huh? She was little, she was probably 6 or 6. She didn't understand that there was an actor. So she couldn't comprehend it. And the mother was like,
how dare you?
She was just kind of like, what? No, you're not. And so we just let it go. I think the coolest thing that happened to me recently, when I was in Nashville, it was my parents, my mom and my stepdad's 20th anniversary, and so we went to this beautiful restaurant, and it was in a top of a, it was like a supper club overlooking the city, and it was a cigar club too. There was a wedding party that was there, and somebody, I don't even know who it was, that was with a spoon of group of people, said to one of the wedding party, that's the voice of John. And so this bride in her wedding gown comes running in, and she's like, oh my god, I'm going to have to sign my wedding dress.
I would so do that.
I'm like, honey, I can't sign your dress. She's like, no, I don't understand. You have to sign your dress. I'm freaking out. And she said, just sign like underneath the hem. So I was like, okay. Do that and try autograph the underwear.
That's awesome.
She was so happy. I was like, wow.
But then you got a dry clean bill from the parents.
No. You can never get it cleaned after that.
And Alita 1 was actually played by Lillian Aragon, who's the voice of Synergy.
Oh, wow.
And I think that Sue Blue did stuff on Transformers. I think Charlie Adler did. I'm pretty sure. I've not been able to meet up with Sue Blue since the show, so I'm hoping at some point I'll get to.
There's one episode of Transformers with all the misfits. Really? Have you seen that?
No.
Yeah.
Which one is it?
I don't know.
It's very sad.
But all the misfits on it. It was weird.
I think she was completely blown away. She's the voice of the family. She's no longer with us. I think she died in 2004.
She did Aja as well, right?
Yeah, she did. She sure did.
So did you work real close with her when you guys were done recording?
It was, yeah, because the holograms would mostly, because we had a lot of scenes together.
Right.
And then it was neat. What I loved about doing Jem was that we recorded ensemble, and I don't know if they use that as much anymore, but it creates a real camaraderie, and there's a lot of room for spontaneous stuff to happen because you're all in a room together and you're all listening and you're all kind of feeling off of each other. So sometimes there was the entire cast sharing microphones, and so you're, you know, being that I had the most dialogue, usually I would make sure with one other person, and then there would sometimes be three people sharing on one mic and just be, you know, looking at your script and making sure you were going, everybody's paying attention and you're knowing like, okay, she's next, so I need to back up.
Right.
That type of thing. And then a lot of the, we call it crowd walla. So there was a lot of that when, you know, you see the you see Jem and the Holograms arriving for events and everybody's going, Aja, Aja.
Yeah.
Hey, that's Jem, Jem. That's us. That's all of
us. Oh, nice.
Like all of us.
Yeah.
Or we're the press, or we're just mumbling. There was this mumbling crowd walla where it couldn't be distinguishable what you were actually saying, mm-hmm. so you have to be on the microphone going, and that we would lose it sometimes because it's so funny. We look around and, you know, just sort of idiot, and people start laughing at each other. And, you know, there were many moments when we got in trouble for laughing. Especially where Patricia, she had quite a foul mouth. And she was like,
yeah, she told us.
I was like the youngest member of the cast, and I was English, and I was raised, you know, I was allowed to use that kind of language, and so she would just make a mistake and just go off. And it was shocking to me at first, but then I loved it. It was so awesome. You know, and she and Charlie would get into it, and then suddenly they'd be having this whole dialogue, and we'd all be like, what's happening?
I was going to ask if she just went off ad-libbing sometimes.
Oh, she would, yeah. And it would not even be on script. And sometimes Wally would just be okay with it and let it happen.
Yeah.
It was awesome.
That would be fun to listen to now.
Oh, I would have
it. Okay,
yeah.
And the guest stars were cool, too. Gosh, what was his name? He played James at 15. You guys remember that show. He did a lot of stuff. I can't remember his name right now, but he came in and did stuff. And I understand James Earl Jones guest starred on.
Really?
Really?
What?
I've been told that, and I never knew that, and I don't know if it's actually.
That's
true.
A recognizable voice.
Star Wars fans, they'll be like, oh my gosh, you're
so.
Darth Vader.
Darth Vader is on James.
So that was.
See, it all comes back together.
Yeah, it's all connected.
Maybe it was related to Sam.
Maybe.
I'm going to have to look that up.
Yeah, I think, I don't know why I haven't looked it up. I just heard it. I was like, thank God, I'm sure I remember that.
How long was it, like, between the time that they told you Jem wasn't going to come back for another season till when it was, like, your last taping? Like, did you have a long time, or was it just, like, you know, they were like, oh, this is going to be the end, and then you had, like, two episodes or
I
something?
I think it was probably, didn't, yeah. I don't remember exactly,
right.
But usually it's like you're hoping you're going to get picked up for another season, and then you don't really know until kind of
the end.
Yeah. I don't think we got a big warning for it.
Right.
And, you know, hindsight, I don't know. Hindsight, I would have been a cheerleader for, let's get some pictures, cast.
Oh, right.
Oh, yeah.
But we just had no idea that the show would just.
Because your last
taping,
everybody went home.
You were the youngest, too.
Yeah, so I was just sort of behaving and trying to do a really good job and do my job.
I think they had planned on continuing that because Hasbro had made a lot of other
The prototype.
Dolls.
Oh,
the 88 stuff. For the fourth season.
Yeah,
and
the
they
dolls,
wouldn't have done that.
The dolls
weren't
doing well.
They weren't doing well.
That was the problem.
There were several.
Now I feel bad that I
bought
more
than
I was
with. My parents probably bought 7 or 8 of them.
Which wasn't usual.
Because, no, I was really, really young.
Uh-huh.
And the Jem doll was the doll that I carried everywhere. And I would lose it, pitch a fit, and I would have to replace it.
Oh, no.
It was the same show.
Oh, no.
I was 3 years old, and I don't know the difference. I just know I love the show.
Yeah.
And it's like, I you know, and it's like, oh look, her earrings work again.
That's hilarious.
I think there were several reasons why it all seemed to do well. One of was they were a different scale than barbing.
Yeah,
oh yeah, they couldn't share the clothes and
at the time.
Yeah.
They couldn't share clothes
and the shoes. They couldn't share the shoes.
Mattel has that license where no doll can be just exactly the same size, so they couldn't do it.
They were a little scary too. I mean,
yeah.
And compared to some of the softer faces on the market with Barbie, the Misfits had very strong
hair.
It's a devil worshiper. You can't buy that.
They weren't scary.
Did you see the prototype for the Pizzazz for the fourth season? And it was like, all this white makeup, like, it looks really, it's on Frantzatron.
Now they are.
It's scary. I only saw it for the first time, like, last year.
Do you know if does anybody know if the dolls that are being released, are they jointed at all?
No.
Yeah.
They have
wrist joints, elbow joints,
knee joints.
They're so detailed.
They have, like, every joint.
They have a torso joint, so they can
go like
this. They're
like these guys somewhat.
Kind of in some way, yeah.
Okay.
They don't have ankle joints. They have the high-heel fashion belt.
Do you know how much they have?
120.
120.
Not including Hollywood Gem, which is
135.
If you're lucky.
But the other
one,
seriously. Yeah, I know. Some people freak out about the price, but I'm like, it's
going to
be a lot.
Yeah. If you wait and get them on eBay, it's triple the price.
The newest release they just had, the holograms, Kimber Ajishenka.
The
as soon as they sell out from the normal retailers, their prices on eBay will skyrocket. So, if you're interested, get them as soon as you can.
They're limited editions.
They're all limited editions.
Like 1,000 of them.
1,000
yeah.
each one. But with Hollywood Gem, some of them are. Some of Classic Gem is pretty much sold out in most places.
You can still get Jerrica.
Integrity has a list of their online registered dealers on their website. The doll dealers who have websites on the internet. And Classic Gem, for the most part, is sold out. You can get her checked. They still have her on eBay at a somewhat well.
Well,
not
it's
600,
marked up big time.
Yeah.
Like triple the
price.
Hollywood Gem was one of an edition of $550.
That was a San Diego
Comic-Con
exclusive.
Sold out almost immediately, and now she's like $699.
And it was originally $130,
so it's
quite a markup.
You can still get Jerrica, Synergy, and Rio from dealers, I believe.
You know, Kimber's coming out, right?
Yeah, Kimber, Shayna.
Those are just released.
Shayna's hair.
She has the football hair.
But it's long, too.
Yeah, I saw those pictures
on
the ball.
Actually, I had them all. I had like all like the hologram stuff, but it was Jim was just the one that is like, if you left the house without it, I would just go on that. Jim was, and I watched the show when I was like all around me turns into Cahuenga. You take Cahuenga and it takes you right into Hollywood, and the T junction and Hollywood Freeway is like right there. And there was this gigantic, beautiful Jim in the holograms. Billboard, you know, watch Gem on the Hub this summer. At night it was all lit up, so it was like neon.
Nice.
It sucks that you don't live here. And I was like, yeah, it really does. That would have been amazing.
Yeah.
At least they did advertising.
Have you seen like all the neon clothes and stuff in the stores now?
It's like walking back into my TV.
Yeah, because we were looking at them. We're like, oh my goodness, if we had money, we could just like dress up like the Misfits.
Yeah,
all the time.
It's all come back. It's so wacky.
It looks just like the clothes on the dolls.
The old neon jelly bracelets are back.
Yeah.
And the pumps, like the neon
pumps.
And then the pizzazz type. Yeah.
Zebra stripes
and
everything.
Have you seen the movie pitch that's on YouTube for a live action Gem movie?
I know there's been a
GB, Goodman, I think, did it. Somebody in the industry hired an actual actress for her name.
I think I have seen her.
I forget. And she holds her, like, she does like this, and there's like light around, but you can see the makeup, the gem makeup, and it shows the different characters cast as actors from today, like different people, and they change the music a little bit. Well, how would you feel if they did some sort of live action gem?
I would love it. I mean, as long as they would keep the sweetness of the show somehow, because I think that's
the magic.
Unique. You know, it's everything today just seems kind of harsh and like aggressive, and I think there was enough of that with the Misfits.
Yeah.
But I think, you know, somebody, I don't know how many people are fans of Taylor Swift, but there's something about her that I really love, because I think that she's got that graciousness, and she's kind to her fans.
She's
and
sweet.
She's got class.
Yeah.
She's a classy girl. And that's somebody that I could see. You know, she's a country singer. But it would be awesome if they cast an unknown.
Yeah.
Yes.
You know, somebody.
Right.
But really, you should be in it if they're going to do it.
I think that would be really fun.
At least a cameo.
Yeah.
I was like, maybe I could be the receptionist at Starlight.
Yeah, there you go.
That would be cool.
You could be Jackie Benton. Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
You could sing and do Jackie Benton.
Yeah. That work.
Yeah.
But you're right, there's a sweetness. And if they could capture it right, then I'd rather them not.
Right.
I know.
Because there's something so magical about the series that is lost on cartoons today.
I agree. And I think, you know, I was a very sort of naive, sort of sheltered in a way, girl. And I feel like that kind of worked in my favor for JEM, because she's not a jaded person. Like, she's very kind and considerate, and that's the way I was raised, and so I think it was a good fit. And I just would love to see what to be involved in casting.
Yeah,
and be like, no, she's a little too edgy. She's not really something.
Right.
Mean streak in her. I don't like that.
Here, move out of the way, I'll show you how.
Right.
I cast Chris that.
Do you think they could do like an animated reboot, like the new My Little Ponies kind of a thing?
That would be amazing.
Yeah.
Because I would love to be Jem.
Right, yeah, me too.
We would start
a
petition. Get Sam to be Jem.
You know, we've talked to a few of the cast members.
Right.
And they would do it in a heartbeat. Even Britta.
Oh, wow.
Cool.
That would be so cool.
Let's win the lottery and make that happen.
Oh, yeah.
How much would that cost?
Yeah,
let's just like start a Kickstarter account and be like,
if
let's
all
bring back
our money,
yeah.
We can buy the rights to JEM and make it.
Christy Mark should be hired for that.
Yeah. Definitely.
Bring everybody back together.
Yeah.
Have you read her new comic book?
I haven't. Amethyst.
Yeah.
I haven't read it yet.
It's good.
I've got
really
it.
Good.
It is good.
Yeah.
But you know what? They canceled it already.
They canceled it already?
Yes.
I didn't know that.
5 issues and it's gone. It was good.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Business is so tough.
Jeez.
It was good though.
It was good.
Yeah, they can't.
She'll
She'll be free to do.
Oh, she's already working on other
stuff.
Exactly. Oh yeah, that's right.
From it being aired on the hub.
You know, there was an issue with that because they weren't paying anybody anything.
Wow.
And so some of the actors and I wasn't in, like. A couple of us were like, you know, I'd rather not make an enemy out of Hasbro personally.
Right.
Over some residuals, I'd rather look forward to possible projects. And then there were some people involved with the show that were angry that we weren't getting paid anything. And I understood that, but, you know, I'm just one little person. So there was talk of a class action lawsuit, and maybe Hasbro got wind of that and they sent us some residuals. But they were very tiny. They were like $5.
At least it was something.
Gas in my car. You know, it was 20-something years ago, 25 years ago. I can't complain, you know. So I'm seeing a lot of kids at this convention, and I just, they look at my billboard, and they're like, and they have no idea what it is. But you know that they would Love it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
There were a lot of little kids at the last GEM Con, and they, when they did the GEM karaoke, they knew the songs, and without even the paper and phone. They were like 6 and 7, and I was like, that is so awesome.
I am meeting some little kids, not here today, but at different conventions. Right. Their moms have turned them on to it, and they're
yeah, I think if they, I don't, because it's not on the hub right now, no. But if they have the DVDs,
it's
you know. That
every kid I know has seen GEM,
well,
made sure of it.
I was telling someone else, now, I have the first release was Rhino, and it wasn't complete, and then the second release was done by Shower,
right.
And that's complete,
and
it's not digitally remastered. It's the original, they took it off the best master tapes that they had from, but somebody went to the trouble of digitally remastering all of them and put them on YouTube.
And it's really well done.
Mr. Howard Sands.
Yeah, I watched those. I showed that to my coworker the other day. They are perfect. Yeah.
And the sound quality is amazing.
Well, I wondered when I watched it on the hub, I was like, the paints are really pink, and the paintings are really green, and I thought, have they done something to them?
Yeah.
They seem to have, like, bumped it up to the next level visually, because I was watching with my mom, and I'm like, really good.
Yeah.
Because
really when you compare the two, it's like Pizzazz's hair and one of them is like
that makes me so mad. It's like the brownish hair.
Yeah, she looks weird with the really dishwatered green hair.
Like mustard color.
Yeah.
What about Raya? Would you like to, I know she's from there and I loved the initial lineup. That's my favorite, you know. But I wouldn't want to knock any other actor out of being able to be working. So I would love to
know why they decided to get a new owner.
I know. Yeah, I'm not sure.
No, I liked her character a lot.
Yeah, I did too.
Why did they change it up?
If I
don't know,
if
they were like,
so
they
could make more dolls.
The dolls too.
Right.
Because the more characters they made, the more dolls.
Mm-hmm.
The more dolls.
And they were going to do graphics.
Mm-hmm.
The show would continue. But then they had actually, she was going to be a new Misfit character, but before the show was even canceled, they slated her because they felt that with the Stinger dolls coming out, they had enough dolls. They didn't want to oversaturate.
What did you think of the Stingers when they added the Stingers and Jem had like another another you know, deception thing going on there? She had too many guys. Riot's voice just cracked me.
He was.
I know, right?
I liked
Riot. Riot was just like, I am Riot.
He was.
I am Riot.
I just loved that, you know, they sort of ended up figuring out why he was, like, so
ridiculous.
He was insecure, and he went back into his past, and kind of
I love that episode.
They had to do that.
That was
Riot's
hope.
Riot's
hope.
Yeah.
If they hadn't done that, he was totally unlikable.
Right.
Even though there were some characters that at first you're like, oh my gosh, they're so hard or mean or whatever, they made it a point to show reasons why, softer sides of the characters, like Minx and Rusher.
And even
Pizzazz. Oh, but they should have had an episode all about Pizzazz. They should have shown
how to read.
Exactly.
You know,
a lot of shows these days don't do that. It's kind of like the whole, okay, they're evil, but why?
But why?
They glorify bad behavior.
Over the top, but she didn't have a mom.
And she was ignored.
And her father just gave her money.
He just threw money at her.
So she was, she had never really been loved.
Yeah.
Because it's like, it just, you know, okay, here you go. Here's another